Let's go to question number 6 and see what modification we have to further make in this part. Let's go to the PDF. So here are some images that is given for question number 6. Let's see what is it saying in the text. So modify this part, same as before, all the inputs, and use the part created in the previous question and modify by using by adding a pocket. Only one pocket on one side. The modified part is not symmetrical. Assume everything is same. What is the overall mass of the part? Okay, so what he is saying is we have to give pocket on this face. As you can see, it goes up to this face, this whole section view you can see. So we can start with the shell command. Using 1mm shell we can do this pocket. So let's see how we can achieve the part. Let's invoke the shell command, take the depth as 1mm, select the face, show preview. Now if you just give the shell like this, it will consider for the whole part. But we don't want that, because the part has specifically mentioned for this section only. As you can see, this is not shared, as well as this face is also not shared. So to overcome that, we'll come to multi-section, multi-thickness settings, and click here, select this face. Now it's taking a offset of 10mm from that face, okay? But we don't want that. In fact, we want this to be up to this face. So if we measure that, let's measure it from this face to this face. 1mm distance is 25mm. So we are going to give our distance here as 25mm. So it will leave all the rest of the part and just give a shell up to 25mm from here. See, now other change that we have to do is we don't see any overlapping hole here, so this part we have to remove. To do that, just select this face, go to sketch, and then just select the face, convert entities, go to extruded cut, and just select to surface, select this surface, press green tick, it will be removed, right? Fine. Now other thing that we observe in the question is we have to give this pocket from this side of the part a 12mm offset. Right now it's only till here. See, this face I'm talking about, it's at an offset of 25 because it is collinear with this face. So let's select this face, go to sketch, convert entities, and then let's go for extruded cut. And we already know that this distance, this thickness is 12. See, sorry, say from this face to this face, now distance is 12mm, right? That we have to give for the pocket. So what I'm gonna do is, instead of this, we'll go to up to surface, select this surface, press the green tick, and I can see it is. Let's go for section view, and section view you can see how your part is looking. So if I change the plane, you can observe all this, right? See, So it's good to use all these tools to see how your part has turned out after the modification. Now I think I have completed all the required modification. Let's go and check the mask properties. So I'll click on mask properties for 32.58. 432.58. It's correct. So this is how you can practice on SOLIDWORKS certified associate exam. This is one of the sample tests that I'm taking for the tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and like this video and share with your friends. Peace out.